human beings want to be happy. We have a need not just to live, but to thrive. At the most basic level, we need food and water for sustenance and shelter from the elements. And even though it may not seem like it when you watch television, we all really do want peace in our lives. We want a sense of purpose and belonging. To put it simply, we each want to feel satisfied with who we are and what we have. We all want good lives.
Troopers, an absolute special delight today. Island Trooper hollering at you here from Vancouver Island, beautiful BC, Canada. And we have an Ermshire UBS-55. This is my friend Scott has come to town here and we're just having a look at it. Right away we can see some major differences between the KB-84 model. Of course, we've got the first gen knobs on the indicator lights. He's got himself a really skookum custom bumper here. And of course the hood scoop. This is a Ford JB1 model, so that is a functional hood scoop for the intercooler. And of course it is a right-hand drive, so we notice right away that the wipers are actually placed differently, right? On a KB84 model, the driver's wiper will be over there and the arms will be in the opposite direction. Then we notice right away he's got these mirrors from Japan. Super cool mirrors. And he was just about to show me some cup holder or something inside. Got Recaro seats, they look very comfortable. Oh, look at this door setup. It's got the cup holder, which is like a coveted plus in a Trooper.
Amazon. Just right over the ashtray.
Right? Where do you ever get a cup holder that doesn't spill the shit out of your coffee in a Trooper? Of course, coffee and beer in a four-wheel drive is never a good idea, but anyways, he's got the automatic package for door windows and locks, and he actually has a really strange fob. Scott, do you want to show us your fob? Look at this thing. It's got a freaking antenna. There's an anti-theft immobilizer attached. It's quite a unit. Automatic power locks for all the doors. And he's rocking 200,000K here. Pretty low kilometers on this baby. Got the 5-speed, of course. Pedal assembly down here. Now, of course, on a right-hand drive, one of the things converting a right-hand to left-hand, the block heaters on the opposite side, or at least, well, not the block heater per se, but the fan is. So the fan that's normally here is not there. He's got the e-brake running through. And they literally just would have switched the driver's console over to where the glove box would be, or vice versa. Black interior. I've never seen black interior in my life. It's awesome. Got a little bit of a map cubby there. Nice little pocket here, like that very much. And some Japanese decals. Let's do a little walk around. This baby is sweet. Got the rack up on the roof with the jack all. Got some beautiful Cooper tires going.
Those are 33 by 10.2.
Oh yeah. Yeah, they look great.
That's about,
and that rear bumper is nice and tight. Little trailer hitch in there. Oh, look at that big beast on the back door.
Right here. Can't go any bigger.
Oh, wow. So if you it'll hit the light.
Yeah.
That is good to know.
No bigger than 33s.
No bigger than 33s. Now, see this rear tire hanger. Oh, you're just missing your plastic clip.
Yeah, I have a bike rack that goes on there.
Right, okay. So that is the same rear tire hanger. But if we put a bigger tire on, it's gonna smack that lens and possibly crack it. That is a nice fit, whoever did this rear bumper. Really nice fit.
Hand grind.
Really, eh? Beautiful. Beautiful sunny day here. March, spring is coming along. And it is time to get trooping. Look at this baby. We're gonna pop the hood and have a look.
Yeah.
Yeah?
I put the boost and the pyrometer in.
Oh, look at this. Sexy gauges. So Scott just informed me. Oh, wow. I love
Amazon.
It's been recarpeted. He's got a new boot on there and just the most gorgeous chrome trim. That is super sweet. And I like this here. That's from the factory, eh?
Yeah.
Wow. I've never seen a heater unit with... Oh, I see. It's kind of a button. It can be stuck on there. That is really sweet with your shift pattern. Not that we need that, but it is a cute little accessory. Oh, and he's got these... Look at these floor mats. They look like a BF Goodrich. Huh. Very sexy. And the black dash. Dude, I have never seen a black dash.
Yeah, it's a good color.
I'm always seeing the two different tones of brown or gray. That's all I ever see.
It looks nice.
It's super awesome. I suppose it would scar easy, but it's in gorgeous shape. So Scott just informed me with the 4JB1 here, he's got his turbo up to 30 pounds of boost, which is just retarded. I can't even believe he's getting those kinds of numbers. Can we have a look at the 4JB1?
Mm-hmm. I'm actually set to 20... between 20 and 25, but it will do 30.
It will, yes.
I won't take it there.
No, and why put that much pressure on it if you don't have to?
This is where I blanked the EGR here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So Scott's done a whole bunch of his own work getting this all together. Scott has, this is your third Trooper?
Yeah.
So Scott has just recently parted with a couple of other Canadian model KB84s. Were they both V6? They both the GM V6?
Yes.
Right, okay, and so Scott brought this here from Japan, and I'm just super stoked because this is one of my first chances to actually look at a genuine Irmscher and to see what they did for the suspension lift and how they did it. You know, for fellas in the Philippines and Indonesia, I know you guys have seen this day in and day out. You know what's going on. But for us North American guys, especially us Canadian guys, we definitely got the raw end of the deal on the diesels. So this is a really exciting deal for me to be able to check this out. And I can see you've got some kind of LED upgrade in your headlights there. Mm-hmm. These huge braid coils. These are actually his heat sinks, which dissipate heat from the bulbs. Whoever says LEDs don't emit heat is lying. They don't emit as much heat as an incandescent, but they do emit heat. And we'll have a quick look at the option codes there. UBS-55, what a sexy beast. Scott's gonna be living in the area, and I get the impression that we're gonna be trooping around together in the future here. So keep your eyes peeled, boys. I will be posting as much as I can. But today, what a delight. Thank you so much for sharing your Trooper with us, Scott.
No problem.
Keep the rubber side down, fellas.
That's what you're doing.
There, we got the 4JB1 running. Just purring like a kitten. Scott's done a few upgrades to get this baby in here. He's got a bypass on the wastegate, and he's having some problems with one of the thermosensors for the cold start. But this is actually the same rad that the 4ZE1 will use. Same $750 radiator. Completely different cowling, but basically the same mechanical clutch driven fan. Oh, what a treat. Island Trooper just drooling over here. What a treat. Gorgeous machine.
It's not that fast, so.
You got hordes of accessory lights. This is your glow plug light here?
No.
Your switch?
That's the old quick warm-up. That's a whole other conversation.
Oh, it is? Mm-hmm. Interesting. I have never seen that toggle before. And you've got a pretty interesting little switch for your fan. Whoa, listen to this thing.
Yeah.
Power windows. Yeah, it's got some good pickup for sure. So did the Recaros come with it?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Definitely sexy. The boost gauge sitting at zero there. Oh, there we go. Holy crap, man. Holy crap. There's a cop shop down here, just so we don't get into trouble. Yeah, this thing picks up and goes. You know, if I was ever gonna pick any vehicle in right-hand drive, I guess I could get used to this. It must be strange shifting with the left hand, though.
I get used to it, you know. It doesn't really get used to it. Affect me too much.
My buddy's got one of those Mitsubishi Delicias, and I'm always going to the driver's door to get in.
Yeah.
And then I like, oh, right, I gotta go around to the other side.
Yeah,
it's,
I do that every
It's
time.
A bit of a mind fuck. Clear. Black dash. Just can't get over that. I don't know what I can do for you for interior parts. Oh, and that dark gray ceiling. Got beautiful. Your headliner is in gorgeous shape.
I know, it's pretty good find.
Oh, and these side pillars, these C-pillars have... Is that a cup?
I put those in.
Ah. So the shoulder belt, it's just a lap belt system in the rear
yeah,
seat?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I put those in when I had the cabinets in the back, because we could have right. beer as well sitting in the back.
£15 to £20, no problem. Uh-huh. Unreal, man. And so you haven't even, since you did your work, you haven't really even had a chance to take it wheeling.
No.
Oh, wow.
Nothing yet.
So Scott's just completed a whole bunch of work. He's just kind of testing it out. It seems like everything he did is working out really good. Fort JB1, baby!
This is Jay with the Damager with Fast Box. Sometimes life gets out of balance, kid. But you know what to do. Peace. Yeah.